Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi class, welcome to the third meeting of speech class. The topic today is about methods of speech delivery. We are going to learn about the way of speech delivery in formal and also in informal ways. So without further ado, let's get started. We already learned about why is it important to learn about public speaking. One of the major reasons for studying public speaking is to learn ways to connect with one audiences and to increase one's confidence in doing so. Speaking in public or public speaking has more formality than talking. During a speech, you should present yourself professionally. Professionally here means that you must wear or dress up or making yourself presentable by wearing clean and also appropriate clothes. And also, it means being prepared to use language correctly and appropriately for the audience and also the topic. How to prepare to the audience? It is to make eye contact with your audience and also to look like you know your topic very well in front of the audiences. Okay. While speaking has has more formality than talking, it has less formality than reading. Speaking allows for meaningful pauses, eye contact, small changes in word order, and also vocal emphasis. Reading is more or less exact replication of words on paper without the use of any nonverbal interpretation. Speaking, as you will realize, if you think about excellent speakers you have seen, heard, and provides more animated message. Okay, so you have in a public speaking class, you have to know the methods of delivery that can help balance between too much formality in giving public speaking. Okay. The main topic today is about speech delivery. There are four ways in delivering the speech. The first one is impromptu speech. The second one is manuscript speech. The third one is memorizing speech. And the last one is extemporaneous speech. But today, we are going to discuss about two ways, which is impromptu speech and manuscript speech. Okay, let's see them one by one. The first way in delivering a speech, it called impromptu speech. What impromptu speech means? It is a presentation of a short message without advance or limited preparation. Jadi impromptu speech itu one of the ways in delivering a speech without advance or limited preparation. Jadi tidak ada langsung, sifatnya langsung impromptu. Preparationnya lebih terbatas, tidak. You don't need much, bukan need much preparation, but it is looks like langsung. You don't have time to prepare yourself. So, you are not going to use a note, but it is better for you to more knowledgeable, to be more knowledgeable. Biasanya speaker untuk impromptu itu sifatnya adalah speaker yang lebih paham dengan topik yang diberikan dalam speech tersebut. Okay, for example, impromptu speech most of the times is informal ways. Kebanyakan itu ada dalam sifatnya informal ya. Now, for example, conversation settings such as self-introductions in a group setting, giving short answer in a discussion, presidential debate or campaign, and also live TV interview. Jadi contohnya itu seperti dalam you are going to introduce yourself in a class, for example. Impromptu, langsung. Nah, the second one is giving short answer in a discussion. When you are having a discussion in a class and you are having a question So you ask the presenter a question, and the presenter give a short answer. Next is presidential debate, debat presiden atau kampanye presiden. Itu sifatnya juga impromptu. And the last one is live TV interview. Okay, what are the advantages and disadvantages of impromptu speech? The first one, the advantages is spontaneous. Nah, the advantages of this kind of speaking is that it is spontaneous and also responsive in an animated group context. And the disadvantages is given little or no time to contemplate the central theme of the message. Keuntungan untuk impromptu ini adalah dia sifatnya spontan, langsung, dan juga langsung sifatnya responsif. Tapi kekurangannya adalah si speaker tidak memiliki waktu yang banyak untuk memikirkan the central theme of the message, pesan atau inti dari informasi atau pesan yang ingin diberikan. Nah, message might be disorganized. Since there is little or no time to contemplate the central theme, the message that the speaker delivered might be disorganized. Karena tidak punya waktu yang cukup untuk menyusun apa yang akan disampaikan, mungkin pesan akan tersampaikan secara disorganized. Disorganized berarti tidak beraturan. Okay. How to deliver good impromptu speech? The first one is maintain the topic. Kita tentukan dulu topik yang akan diberikan itu tentang apa. Nah, organize the address. Apa tujuan dari speech tersebut? Kita harus keep in our mind what you are going to speak related with the topic. And then you also have to think about four parts of impromptu speech. The first one is introduction, the second one is main idea, the third one is supporting evidence and conclusion. In order to make or to avoid the message disorganized, you have to know the part of impromptu speech. Start from introduction, main idea, supporting evidence, and also conclusion. Jadi untuk menghindari adanya pesan atau memberikan informasi secara acak tadi, tidak beraturan, jadi kita harus menyusun dengan berdasarkan 4 bagian dari impromptu speech. Ada pendahuluan, lalu masuk ke main idea, mendukung main idea, dan yang terakhir jangan lupa ditutup dengan conclusion. Now, let's come to the second type of ways in delivering speech. It is called manuscript speech. Manuscript speech is manuscript speech refers to the word-for-word iteration of a written message. So, in a manuscript speech, the speaker maintains his or her attention on the printed page except when using visual aids. Nah, in manuscript speech, speaker reads a pre-written speech word by word. Dalam manuskrip atau jenis pidato berdasarkan manuskrip, si pembicara lebih fokus kepada printed page of pre-written speech. Jadi pidatonya itu atau hal yang ingin disampaikan itu sudah ditulis duluan sebelum disampaikan secara oral. Nah, it is read to printed document or teleprompter. Jadi yang dibacakan oleh speaker using manuscript speech is printed document, menggunakan kertas atau manuskrip ya, atau teleprompter. Teleprompter itu seperti yang digunakan oleh news anchor pembawa berita. Ada sebuah alat namanya teleprompter, jadi itu yang dibaca ketika menyampaikan sebuah berita atau news. Nah, in manuscript, The content of the talk is prime importance. Jadi dalam manuskrip tadi, hal yang paling penting atau difokuskan adalah the content of the talk, isinya. Contohnya adalah in official meetings, dalam rapat. Jadi dalam rapat pasti ada konten yang harus disampaikan, hal yang penting. Atau dalam conference. Dan contoh lainnya adalah in a wedding speech atau pidato di acara pernikahan. And the last one in televised news report atau pembawa berita ditampilkan di televisi. Okay, now let's come to the advantages and disadvantages of manuscript speech. The first one is effective when put forth on in time. Karena fokusnya tadi pada konten, jadi akan lebih efektif menggunakan manuscript speech. Fokusnya ada pada konten yang penting, tapi disampaikan dalam waktu yang singkat. Nah, concise and accurate information is conveyed. Jadi tujuannya adalah menyampaikan informasi yang akurat. Nah, what are the disadvantages? The first one is may not attract any attention of audience. Karena tadi fokus on a printed document, karena fokusnya kepada teks, pada teleprompter, jadi tidak akan menarik bagi si audience. Karena si pembicara fokus kepada dokumen saja. So, it makes the natural flow of speaker apa? Karena fokus kepada printed tadi, eye contact, dan juga the way she or he talk naturally is lost. Jadi, karena fokus kepada dokumen tadi atau teks tadi, maka eye contact akan berkurang. Nah, itu akan membuat si audience tidak tertarik untuk mendengarkan speech yang diberikan. Okay. Now, how to deliver a good manuscript speech? The first one is use light pastel paper. Apa maksudnya light pastel paper ini? Karena manuscript itu menggunakan catatan, jadi sebaiknya ketika kita memberikan pidato atau speech secara manuskrip, gunakan kertas yang berwarna pastel, karena itu akan menghindari adanya pantulan cahaya ketika membaca dokumen atau teks tersebut. Make sure the written speech is in a bigger font size than normal and double the space. Kalau misalnya kita menggunakan dokumen yang ukuran fontnya lebih kecil, tentu akan lebih sulit dibaca dan akan terjadi pause yang cukup lama ketika memberikan speech. Nah, jadi gunakan font yang lebih besar dan juga spasinya secara double. Next, mark the pauses with symbol, slash, or highlight. Nah, jadi ketika membaca manuskrip tadi, tidak asal membaca ya. Membacanya tentu ada pause-nya, ada jedanya, ada rising intonation-nya, ada falling intonation-nya. Jadi gunakan simbol. Simbol bagaimana maksudnya? Di mana kita harus berhenti, di mana kita harus menaikkan intonasi, di mana kita harus menurunkan intonasi. Jadi di dalam dokumen itu harus ada simbol-simbol yang bisa dimengerti oleh si pemberi pidato sendiri. Nah, next, don't try to memorize the speech. Let it come to the flow. Jangan menghafal. Biarkan itu mengalir seperti apa adanya. Karena kalau kita memorize the speech, akan kelihatan kalau kita thinking during the speech delivering. Akan terlihat kalau kita sedang mengingat. Jadi itu akan mengurangi adanya eye contact, ada kurangnya facial expression. Nah, maintain frequent eye contact and facial expression. Walaupun namanya manuscript speech, jadi ini tidak mata tidak hanya fokus kepada dokumen all the time, tidak, tapi maintain frequent eye contact. Perhatikan juga adanya eye contact ketika membaca, perhatikan audience. Gunakan eye contact. Lalu control your facial expression. Kendalikan ekspresi wajah. Kapan kita harus tersenyum, kapan kita harus menunjukkan wajah yang serius, itu juga harus kita perhatikan ketika giving a manuscript speech. Nah, so this is the question for quiz meeting 3. The first one is, what is the importance of impromptu speech? The second one, mention the major characteristic of impromptu speech. The last one is, what advice you can give to make manuscript speech not boring? So, you have to answer these three questions and then submit your answer on our e-learning platform based on the due date. Okay, class, this is the end of our class today for meeting 3. I hope you understand about the material well. See you next time. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.